Hallelujah. us faithful graces this morning. We thank you, Lord God, and the Father, still for us. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord.
Hey!
Mayo, Tango!
You are the testimony to people, to
others. Because
the more you make mistakes,
the more you
learn.
After
you make a mistake,
he's there to
pick you
up. It's when
you die in your
mind. I love God to pick you up
from mistakes. He promised us
that
he has written our name in his power. Now,
what happened
this Sunday?
Is
this
Kamalakola?
I can't go
to the Raba.
I want
to talk
at the Pumula.
Live on one leg here. Now, we
saw
the Kulukuluan.
But I'll give you a man
who gets the Lama. But I'll give you an hour.
It's not yet over.
Message today,
I don't know why did I go through this, but I want to tell someone today
that
he has forgiven you. But Pastor, how can I worship? Yesterday I did this. Yesterday is in the past.
Wow.
When the Bible reminds you about you, what you did to
him, remind
him about his future.
He
is having a future in the kingdom of God.
Already
defeated. The person that preached the gospel to me, he was from jail for 21 years. He used to hit banks. He used to do things. But the day evangelist Jesus Christ came to touch him,
the day the gospel of Jesus touched his life,
he was transformed.
We are apeto.
Transformation.
Petro.
Let's preach more, was the Lord.
Let's
open our Bibles. Can we preach? Let's preach.
Amen.
Let's open our Bibles in the book of Matthew, chapter 17, verse 20.
Jesus a petula ar. Kika ubane le saela tumelo ruri ke le botsa gore ge le ka ba le na le tumelo ye le kana go le tshwarana ya mpho le be le ka botsa thaba ye la re tloga mo o ye mola
tshware mo tshwane e fela
tiki khutlo o tsama e fela le be le ka se shitwe ke selo
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Matthew 17:20. He said to them,
Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21. Yeah.
Because of the littleness of your faith, that is lack of firmly relying trust. For truly I say to you, if you have faith that is living, like a grain of mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to yonder place, and it will move.
Come on,
and nothing will be impossible to you.
Not to Jesus, to you. Okay, read it for us.
Death and life are in the power of the tongue.
Okay.
And they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof.
Repeat it again.
Death and life are in the power of the tongue. And they that love it shall eat the fruit.
Now, as children of God, what we need to understand is that
there
is what we call the next level. The reason why I'm preaching about this message today, as I was preparing this message, ask Mama Ruth, I finished preparing my message yesterday.
And
this morning the Lord woke me up and tell you people this. You have celebrated your glory too much.
phalelo ya lena.
Failing to see the next level
where we.
Some of us have been successful in a lot of things. But it's not what God has sent in you to. That is the next level where God wants you to go. To go to the next level. You need to stop celebrating this now. Because you're celebrating too much without the movement. Without the motion. It becomes a monument.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen. Monument was a monument. Amen. You want to stand us some bonus tangas and scholars? But I was a long one. She's so beautiful. Mama, thank you very much, Mom. Too. You're looking beautiful this morning.
No.
In order for us to go to the next level, stop celebrating what we have achieved now.
We
have achieved a lot of things. Yes, I agree. But it's not enough. God is about to take you to the next level. The biggest mistake that the children of Israel did, it was to celebrate the departure from Egypt. Look at your neighbor and say to him, you have celebrated too long. You have celebrated too long. Now, as the children of God, we need to understand one thing, that we are designed to move from one glory to another glory. No matter the glory you have seen,
there is
another glory that you never
have seen.
There is a truck and a house that you must build. You have celebrated your car too long. Move to your new house. Move to your new company. You cannot celebrate while you are still under pressure.
Amen.
No. When we want to understand the movement of God, stop celebrating too long. Most of us are wandering in the wilderness. The reason why whatever that you have achieved, it doesn't make you happy anymore. Because you have celebrated it too long. Most of us are still celebrating. Not in Canaan. But in the wilderness. Azalana, I've got a bad news today. There is nothing that God can do now. Especially if you are the believer of the New Testament. The Holy Ghost is given unto us. Jesus has died.
Jesu wila aya
buya ba. The kingdom of God is provided. Mushwa
mudimu le wafiwa.
Blessings has been released.
Di chogo fato di alokola.
Healing has been given.
Polo ile ya
fiwa. There is nothing that God can do anymore.
I want to tell mudimu aga sata sa idie. Chote di dirile.
Yeah. There is nothing that God can do anymore. God has emptied himself. God has already
released.
Everything that you want is in the shelf.
Yeah.
So what you want to do is to stand up. Because you have been wired with abilities to create the atmosphere so that the things that are on the shelf can be released.
Hallelujah.
Ntabazo cannot ask me 500 rand.
Ntabazo can ask me 500.
Already I've given him 5,000 before that, the beginning of the year.
Give me 5,000 before the beginning of the year.
Come on, 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 come on,
You get out of his house naked.
He was wearing his things.
So
he can shift the focus on me to focus on God, but to focus on things. Why do you have a little? Because they understand that greater is the one that is inside. God is not confused. He cannot give you what he has already given you. I don't mind waiting too much. God is waiting for you.
Yes.
Not you waiting for him. Your greetings determine who you are. You must know that they have already seen your marriage. No. Because they understand, they see you as a married woman. When people greet you, they don't greet you. They greet you according to what they see in you. Mighty man of valor. I ordain you. I set you up before you were born. Don't appear to people as a beggar. Appear to people so that they can prophesy over your life. They will never even start asking you about your wife. So people, let me tell you something. To use faith is easy. It's to tap to what is inside you. The problem with us, we don't have faith in what we have believed. Jesus says, I tell you the truth, if you have faith, in the past tense, some of you are not the reflect of what you're supposed to be. I'm talking to you. It is God that wants us to go from one level to another level. But there is this spirit of delay in your life that you are entertaining. If you are not aware of this spirit, you will entertain the spirit of delay and you will stuck. Most of us are delayed to receive what we're supposed to do. Because we are celebrating in the wilderness. The spirit of delay in your life is the one that is holding you back. I hate the word patient with passion. People will tell you that have patience in the Lord. God is not at work. No, God is done already. God has already released it. According to me, the word patience means waiting when the process is working. Waiting when the process is working. Waiting when the process is doing what? Waiting when the process is doing what? No. You cannot tell me that be patient for food while there's nothing on the oven or on the stove. Which food? Now we like to do. If you tell me about to wait and be patient, it's when something is on the oven. It's when I smell it. Nothing is a wrong one. Because you cannot tell me about waiting if there's nothing to wait for. I'm tired of waiting. Of the love that I don't know what it's going to give me tomorrow. You are not going to be blessed, you are blessed already. Meaning that you are the one that chooses when to be blessed. It's not God who chooses when are you going to be blessed. It's, you. It's not God. It's not God who chooses when to bless you. If the man that was blind, if he didn't make a noise, Jesus was going to pass. It's you who decide when you're going to get blessed. Abraham, blessings are mine. Abraham, your seed will grow. It's already been given. That is why it is. Washalo panti, washalo kono.
Wajula fasi.
Kutichi wengempilo ya.
Kupula ba au banana kubule ba filani.
Already in the beginning.
Wena ukino wakulele la matomo.
All that you need to do.
Sometimes you sit like this.
The menu is given.
Menu ki khalo fi.
When are you chosen? When do you want to eat? You can start with water level. You can start with dry level. You can start with
water level. You can start
with water level. You can start with water
level. Must prepare your stomach.
I worship Kuma Milodi.
Come and walk with me to Mr. Kuma Milodi.
My pastor was so blessed. And he took me to a hotel. And when I get there, when he get there, he said, Tabang, eat everything. I didn't start again. Then Bishop stand up and say, Tabang, I'm going to start eating now. Choose what you eat.
Wala khatarna kuja.
Put it to your lips. I will give you the desire of your
life.
What you desire is already.
Say when else Nagas in the city.
All that you need to do is to do what
else Nagas is to do.
If you had a car before your house, because you know that the house is already on the pipeline. It's in the
menu.
It's in the menu.
It was a menu.
The wife that you want is in the menu.
When
you choose what to, when are you going to get married?
When
are you going to get married? You choose! It's in the menu! you want. That is what you call a starter. And most of us will celebrate starter and forget about we pray for you here, you celebrate your blessings. You celebrate the starter. That's the reason why we are stressed in the wilderness. We will never experience cane and milk. I'm sure God has already given us.
Yeah.
It's powerful.
The problem with you, after you get a peace job, you celebrate too.
Go for down to cry, Merconia, and I am with our sin. When I
was with our sin, you stop coming to church, you celebrate. There is a great thing that God has in store for you before then. Look at your neighbor, say you have celebrated too long. It's time you celebrate. If you wait, time might pass. If you want to, some of us, our season have already passed. That is why Ogranta Tomohulu, after the skinny jean, I'm a cover. The season has passed. The season has
passed.
When the season passed,
is it that the
thing? What can I
keep the
Look, the blind man, they said to him, and what are so?
I'm not going to
shut up. When it's your season, you can feel that
this is like a
Jesus,
of blessings.
Well, now you can't call the
You have cried too long. Wipe your chest.
When I pull
and create the atmosphere of blessing.
When I would come like
you tell God that says you send silver and gold to
believe.
And as my father, I've got the portion in what you own.
That
the problem with us, we have celebrated too long. Proverbs chapter 18, verse 23.
DM 18.
Here we stand. We proclaim. is mine. Miracle is mine. Because today I need a miracle. Create the atmosphere.
I'm going to go to the house.
What you say with your mouth?
Seo se bolela ka molomo. Se tla go tswala
dintsi. And at the minute you start speaking it,
ge o thoma o e bolela,
it becomes real.
E ba ntho leng gore ke a pale.
Because through what you say,
o tse wena o di bolelao,
you can kill and you can build.
Wena o ka bolaya o ka a.
Ke itebella e mo ntse o kore. If you speak negative about your situation every time, you say, "I hope I did it. Not very good. I cancer." You are idiot.
If you speak negative things,
have you ever complained about something and it end up becomes your part of your life? As I'm speaking right now, people were, in the morning, they took almost 4 pills to come to church. Every time is a headache at night, you can't sleep at night. What did you say with your
lips?
Stop destroying yourself. And start speaking life. I want us to declare today. And declare your atmosphere.
Yes,
what you're going through, I'm not going through. I'm not going to be cute and pray for them in the name of Jesus.
I'm
going to stand and say, Father, I decree and declare that what the day that I stolen from my family
is not.
You have been begging the devil too much. He has stolen your things, you are happy. He has stolen your joy, you are happy. He has taken your husband and your children, you are happy. And you act as if nothing. It's about time you step and tell the devil and say, my family, you will never take my children, you will never take my wife, you will never take my husband. I declare and declare. Don't be cute. If you want to move out of the chair, we're giving you an opportunity today. Move out of the chair and start declaring. Father, we thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, we give you the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, walk out of your chair. If you feel that where you are, you're not going to be free in terms of prayer, I'm giving you a freedom and an opportunity to move around. If you are happy with your situation, you'll remain there. But today I want us to come out in the name of Jesus. Pastor Job, come to the prayer, Bakaya. Come on. Walk out of the chair.
Father, in the name of Jesus, this afternoon, Lord, we decree and we declare that because you have already released everything and it is already on the shelf, it is for us to keep. You say in your word that everything in the house belongs to us. It is already for us, the children. Therefore, today we speak it because we know it is in our inheritance. This is what is in the bloodline. This is what you have placed for us, and no one can take it away from us. Healing is already ours. Every single body, every single cell. Today, healing is the portion and it is working. It has already been released. And as we speak in the pledge of Pasema Kosi, I will learn to a sala emuva. Christo. decree and we declare that all finances, all wealth, as it is spoken today, it fills up our coffers and our vests in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, our ministry, our gifting, they have told us that the devil has stolen it, but we know that it was given to us. It is an inheritance. Every single purpose, every single gifting, Lord, it is activated today in the name of Jesus Christ. No one is going to sit back. Those that are sitting in darkness, you say, let there be light. Therefore, there is revelation. And Father, we decree and we declare that revelation falls upon each and every person today. They recognize and they know, Lord, when they are not hearing your voice, now, Father, we decree and we declare that all ears are open in the name of
Jesus. I come against the spirit of delay in our lives right now in the name of Jesus. I pray that, Lord, in the Father, we accelerate right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I come against the spirit of delay right now in Jesus' name. Right now in the name of Jesus, we break every spirit right now in Jesus' name. Right now, Priya Mama Sakaya, Priya Mama Sakaya.
Receive your healing right now. Receive your healing right now. Receive your healing right now. Power. She's not going to live in her regret. I speak right now that she will match up and forget about what happened. Right now in Jesus' name. Receive your power. Receive your healing. Right now in the name of Jesus. Receive your healing. Receive your healing right now. In Jesus' name. You are healed right now. You are healed right now. Right now in Jesus' name. Power of the Holy Ghost. Upon her right now in Jesus' name. If you need the healing of soul today,
you
are at the right place today in the name of Jesus.
There
are so many things that have happened in your life that you don't want, you cannot forget. Every time when you want to go with life, no, go on with life. There is something that is bringing those things back. But today I pray right now in Jesus' name. Let the power of the Holy Ghost right now be upon you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, receive your healing right now. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lord, you are a healer. Heal their souls, oh God. They went through some issues of life. I speak life right now in the name of Jesus. Power in Jesus' name. May he forget what she's going through. May you heal her right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Take your healing right now. Let the power of the Holy Ghost be upon her. In the name of Jesus. The power of the Holy Ghost minister to her right now in Jesus' name. Pray for your power of the Holy Ghost. Every challenge that she's facing, I speak out that Lord Heavenly Father, you are the only person that is able to heal. I declare and decree tonight, this morning, O God. We command it right now in the name of Jesus.
at our feet. I want you to pray after me and say, Father, in the name of Jesus. I can hear you, Father, in the name of Jesus. You know my heart. You know my challenges. Today, this morning, in the name of Jesus, I declare and decree that every challenge that comes in my life is defeated in the name of Jesus. Everything that I'm facing right now, I speak love upon it right now in the name of Jesus. I declare that there is no weapon that is formed against me that will prosper. I speak love right now. Everything that doesn't give me joy, I speak joy of the Lord upon it right now. In Jesus' name, I declare that everything that the devil has stolen from me, I declare and decree that the Lord will make him to vomit it right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We honor you, oh God, in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, let's have hands. Can we make a clap on us unto the Lord? Things that they can happen.
Yes.
And it's you who decide when I'm going to get blessed. And it's you who's deciding when I'm coming in season. I don't know if you have had me today. Don't sit and die in a season that is not yours. Don't die in a season that was not designed for you. You are designed for greater things. Manjan, I want you to pray a prayer that is consolidating everything that is happening today.
Any other God like you, Father.
has called you to come and do certain things. Don't try to replace what God has called you for with other things. I want you to take the issue of salvation seriously. I see you ministering to different people, and the Lord is going to make it through you. Never judge yourself about the things that you've done previously. Yes, you have run away from all this, but God is about to do a new thing in your life. God is about to restore your life back to the way it was supposed to be. I want to pray for you, sir, and God is going to help you. Father, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, there are a lot of things that is going through this man's life. I pray that right now, everything that the devil has delayed him with, I pray that, Lord, may you accelerate it right now in the name of Jesus. He has been begging people to help them. He has been begging door by door. But today I release your power upon this man right now in Jesus' name.
Yes,
I speak right in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Whatever that you're promising, oh God, I call it upon him right now. In Jesus' name, right now. In Jesus' name, I thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Sorry for coming late, but I know the Spirit of the Lord was at work. If you never heard an announcement, I was going to say, let's just go now and allow the Spirit of the Lord to come into us. With the same mood. Without closing the service, we're just saying, let's go home with the power of the Lord. There is a shift in the atmosphere in this room.
Oh, come on. Come on.
There are people that are hiding their gift. There are prophets of God that are seated in this church. And the Lord wants to root them out so that they can be seen. You cannot hide from what God has given you. We've got prayer warriors that are hidden in the church. We've got people that are hidden that God wants to use. But they say who they are. But God says this morning, what I have given you, there is no one that can hide it. It's about time we do well with the gift that God has given you. In Jesus' name. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Today's message, I believe, was not just my message. I'm just saying, I go to put on Shadi Santa. I think I'll go to Zaire. Today's message was my message. I personalized it. And it speaks unto the situation in your life. It speaks unto every single obstacle in your life. And here's what God was saying to me, you know, when we pray, it is not to make God do things in our lives, but it is for us to do what God wants to do in our lives. God is not summoned by our prayer. But you see, when we pray, we are putting ourselves in alignment with what God wants to do, main philosophy. It is when we are being submissive. It is when we unloose every single thing that God has done. Umfundisi spoke that we should speak to the mountain. God doesn't say that he will move that mountain for you. He says, you speak to that mountain. You have that power to speak to that mountain. What power? Several from this. Our announcements, I'm here to give you announcements that are as follows. On the 31st of August,